Welcome, and joining me today via Skype is Martin Sinclair, who is the founder and creator of vMix. How are you today?
Great, George. It's great to be here.
Yeah, well, welcome again. And again, Martin Sinclair is the person who made vMix possible for all of us. And for those that may not know, can you tell us what vMix is?
Yeah, so vMix is a live production solution that pretty much allows anybody to create a live show or record a live production and then stream that to the web.
Yeah, and there's so many different things you can do with vMix, multiple cameras, bringing in photos and presentations and so many things. How did vMix come about? And you said that was a solution that you needed for yourself.
Yeah. So many years ago, around 2005, I was looking to record a Christmas carols show for our church, and they were looking to spend a lot of money on a live production system because at that time things were very expensive. One of the ones out there that was in standard definition for four cameras was around $25,000.
Yes.
So this is a very, very, very big investment. And I had experience in programming since high school, and I thought that would be a challenge. I didn't necessarily expect I would be able to build such a thing, but I got some basic ability there for a couple of cameras connected via USB, and that's how the first video recording of the Christmas carol service got put together.
And it's grown and grown and grown. And I think when I first experienced vMix, I was looking for the same thing, something that I could put a couple webcams together on, and I'd found some software out there, and all of a sudden I come along vMix, and I went, whoa, this is just, it's almost too good to believe. It's just it was perfect. And so far I think that was at least version 8, and now we're on version 15, and it just continues to get better. When you just finished a very successful show out in Las Vegas, a very successful show, and some folks were employing your vMix solution to do the live show out there.
Yeah, so we were at the NAB live show in Las Vegas, which ran for 4 days about 2 weeks ago now. And Teradek, who we worked very closely with on supporting a lot of their products,
right,
they've chosen to use vMix for their live show now for the last 2 years. And so we provided them the vMix Go, which is our latest turnkey hardware solution running vMix. And that ran nonstop for 4 days, never had a single glitch, just ran really, really well. And it was a great, case study of using vMix out there for a very dynamic production, because they have guests coming on every 30 minutes,
yeah,
new hosts, everything's always changing, keeping,
yeah,
the crew there on their toes. And I guess vMix was just the switcher in the side of things. The team there did a really great job, but it was great to work with Teradek and produce this live show for them.
It takes a, when you put yourself in that position with your software, I mean, it's going to take a very reliable, robust system to pull this off. I mean, it's just, and again, I watched several hours of their show out there, and it was just, again, terrific. You say you broadcast live for 4 days?
That's right. So they ran from 9 a.m. till 6 p.m. Every day for 4 days, Monday to Thursday.
Yeah, I watched the show, and it was just terrific, and the host is terrific, and he's very, very impressed with your product, and very impressed with what you've done over the years, and things. There's some folks looking at vMix out at the show, some pretty interesting people looking at vMix. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, so outside of the show, we have all sorts of different customers, and customers really are what build the feature set in vMix. So you, as you've said, there's been a lot of stuff that's going in there since vMix 8. When you started out there, all of those features come from the customer feedback. So when we were building the vMix Go system, a lot of what went into that was based on Teradex, you know, doing their show last year in 2013 and building on that and adding the features on the customers. So we have customers in all these different areas, you know, churches, people recording concerts, even customers using the chroma key feature in vMix on a film set just so they can get some live, you know, footage together of what the, you know, film might look like before it's been edited.
Yeah.
So a lot of different areas that vMix is used in, and I guess I'd call it, you know, a bit of a Swiss Army knife of video production, because not only does it do the live streaming and the production, but there's so many little features in there that are all based on the customer feedback that we've received that have made it so versatile and useful in so many, many different areas.
Right, and it is a very versatile. I use it here all the time. I do a lot of recording videos with it, and we do a live stream show every week up on YouTube. Now, vMix offers several different packages, and for ever since I think you started, you've offered a free package for people who just need something for simple video recording or live streaming, all the way up to 4K with 4K replay.
Yeah, that's right. So it started with a vMix basic version, which is just standard definition, allowing you to bring up to a few cameras by USB, webcams, and you know, get everything together for production, all the way up to our new vMix Pro version, which has instant replay capabilities for four cameras simultaneously. So that's all the way from free to $1,200. And then we've got everything in between. So really that was just designed to make it as affordable as possible for each of these different customers so that everybody doesn't have to buy the most expensive version if they only need a couple of the features.
Right. And again, that's just terrific. And then you have also, and I used this when I got vMix, you have a 60-day free trial that has no branding, and I think it offers everything that vMix is capable of. Is that correct?
Yeah, yeah. So the trial was designed so that customers could use it in real-world scenarios without any logos appearing over the top or things like that. And I thought that was really important for vMix, I guess, to sell itself. A customer will see whether it suits their requirements and they'll go ahead and buy it. Whereas if we try to restrict the trial in any way, they may not be entirely sure and maybe hesitant to buy it without knowing if it definitely works for them.
Right. I used that 60-day free trial, and again, it gave me enough time to figure out if it was something I wanted, and I did want, and then I went ahead and I purchased the software, and since then I bumped up, and what I had originally purchased and using another version, it allows me to do more things. But there's also some free software that vMix offers its customers without, again, any charge that possibly, you know, some people might might charge for, but you offer a desktop capture that people can bring information in from other computers, and that's both for Windows and Mac. And you also offer a title editor. Now, a title editor comes in with every version of vMix, correct?
Yeah, yeah. So the title editor is free alongside the desktop capture application you mentioned. And what we also have for free now is vMix Social. So the ability to bring in Twitter and Facebook comments live. And I've noticed you've been using that on a few of your shows, which is great.
Right.
So all of these add-ons are really just to enhance the capabilities of vMix even more, but also providing them for free as, you know, I guess our main business is vMix. And these are all these plugins and stuff that we provide for free on top of that.
Yeah, I just brought up vMix Social here, Twitter. I use Twitter on my vMix Social, but you can bring in, of course, Twitter, and you can bring in Facebook if you want to, and you can also bring in IRC chat. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct. So IRC chat's been used on a couple other shows as well, such as Studio Tech Live. They used that for a couple weeks as well because they have an IRC chat room. Was just providing all these different elements for different shows based again on customer feedback.
Right, right. And again, there's a lot of support for vMix. I mean, you can get a lot of support for vMix. You've got a lot of support on your website. You've got something that I check often if I have, you know, something that I need to know more above what I've done so far is your forums. Those folks there are just really, really enjoy helping other people who use vMix to make sure that it, you know, whatever you ask questions and you get feedback. I mean, you know, I asked a question, some gentleman up there was using Windows 10 with vMix, and I'm very, very interested in how Windows 10, you know, is going to be. And he, except for a problem with Windows 10, he said vMix worked fine with that. And it's coming out. Windows 10 is supposed to come out perhaps this summer.
Yeah, so we've been very fortunate to have an amazing community over in the forums there, and everybody there has just been really great, providing feedback, helping others out, and even, you know, educating users on features of vMix I didn't even think, you know, to put two and two together. The ways they've been putting things together and the really amazing solutions they've come up with has just blown me away.
Yeah. Let's talk a little bit about some products you added just a while back, and those are vMix Go, and you also have another solution. Can you tell us just a little bit about those?
Yeah, so vMix Go is our complete system, flagship system that we used for the Teradek live show. And so it has 8 SDI inputs, or it can have 6 inputs, 2 outputs. It has analog audio input and output capabilities. It's got a built-in screen. It's got a handle so you can carry it around. The vMix Go is just really just designed to be portable and to take it wherever you need it to go.
Yeah.
So that's our flagship. That's around $10,000 for 8 inputs. For 8 SDI inputs, and we also have the vMix Thunder, which is a smaller, more compact box, which we've worked with AJA to put together, which is their box, which has 4 SDI inputs, 1 HDMI input, or you can use some of those as outputs as well, and that connects via Thunderbolt to a Thunderbolt laptop. So at the NAB show, we added a laptop by MSI, which is their MSI workstation laptop, and that has a Thunderbolt port, so all they need is that laptop in their bag, the vMix Thunder box from AJA, and they've got everything they need to do a 4-camera production on the road. And one of our new announcements this year as well is a new control surface that we've been working on for some time now. So the control surface should be out sometime in May, and that provides buttons and T-bar control just like a traditional hardware switcher. So there are 3 major hardware products, and as always, we're continually adding new features to the software side of things as well. So users who just use the software will never be left out. But we have these great hardware solutions if, I guess, customers just want to buy something and know it works straight out of the box.
Yeah, and it does. And for someone who needs a turnkey solution, you have these already, and they can just a little bit of time, get these set up and do whatever, you know, they want to do as far as video production. And again, when I first seen vMix and had it on my computer, it's just like can have one of these satellite trucks, kind of how they're set up when they come in to do something, you know, at a different place and have all the input. And the thing I really like about vMix, and I've said this before, is when you're using vMix to do video production, whether you're doing live streaming or recording, it's what you see is what you get. Everything's laid out in a very systematic way. You know, you don't have to go through modules to set something up. It's just bring that content in and use it for your show.
Yeah, and that it's, you know, vMix has been designed, as I said at the start, about my requirements and what I needed to do a show. And so it was really just based on a real world situation that I needed. And then since then, we've gotten customer feedback. You know, customers have emailed us and said, oh, wouldn't it be great if we had this button here or this button there that does that functionality, because that would save me a lot of time. And I've, you know, thought, great, let's add that in there. So it really has been designed based on how customers want to do stuff quickly and easily when putting together live video.
Right. You know, we do, again, live shows here, and one person can handle this and do a lot of different things with vMix, different screens and different titles and social and everything else. Now, they can download the free version of vMix from your site, but you also have some resellers all over the world who can supply vMix and do help you get started with vMix, don't you? They can find that on your site.
Yeah, so vmixhd.com is the website to go to find out all of that information, download a trial, or contact our resellers. And we've been building up a lot of resellers within the United States especially. So there's a big list there in most areas, in most states now, where customers can, contact a reseller to either just purchase vMix or vMix Go and our other hardware options, right, or to have a custom solution. We have a couple of resellers out there, such as Tom Sinclair, who builds systems, right, especially for our customers. That's been great as well.
Yeah, I watch his show all the time, and he talks about vMix, and he puts on different demonstrations how you can use vMix and what you can do with it. Now, you also have third-party folks that's come in and created some solutions for vMix. One of them is different studio effects, and I've used these before, but there's a lot of other third-party coming in and designing software and other solutions for vMix.
Yeah, we've seen as part of that great community that people have been a part of on the forums, a few users there are now setting up their own small businesses, building effects and add-ons and titles and scoreboards and all sorts of great add-ons for vMix. So it's just been amazing to see, and I check out the forums on a very regular basis, seeing all these new solutions that people have put out there. But also on the training side of things, it's been great to see people put together videos on YouTube to help people out.
Yeah.
And you especially have seen a lot of your videos that are just helping users out and how to put videos, and your expertise as you've been learning vMix, it's just been great to see you put that out there so others can also learn from it as well.
Well, thank you. But what I like to do, I like to play with vMix and see what it is capable of and see what different things that it can be used for. I've used it for a teleprompter, and I've done some other things, and you've already up to 4K. Folks can do 4K if they want to. And there's a neat thing about 4K that I did a little demo on but 4K makes this look so much better. If you're doing a video in 4K and streaming it in 1080 HD, what you can do with that is actually crop your shot a lot better with 4K because the video is so large, and turn like one camera into three almost at times, can't you?
Yeah, and we've seen users use that for sports as well. We have a single 4K camera just on the entire soccer field and then turn that into four virtual cameras of each particular location. So it's a great way, to take advantage of that resolution, and don't have to buy four cameras. You can just use one 4K.
You can actually use one 4K to pull something like that off. I seen you do, I would talk just a little bit about the four camera instant replay. I seen you use this at the out there at the show in Las Vegas, and how that was just, it was so amazing what, slow motion replay. And I've also watched some videos on the forums where folks are doing sports and instant replay, and it's just, again, tremendous. Now, you're going to be out on the East Coast here pretty soon, and folks can have a chance to speak with you and see what vMix can do.
Yeah, 2 weeks from now, we'll be at Streaming Media East in New York, at the Hilton Midtown. So that'll be a great event. Stream Media events, always great to come along and check out all the various booths and check us out, and we can give you live demos with that. And also a month after that, we'll be at Infocom down in Orlando, Florida.
Okay.
So that's a great vacation spot for me especially, but also it's a great show. First time we're at Infocom, and that's a really huge event, so it'll be interesting to see. But people could come along and check out vMix at either of those.
Okay.
And you know, great to have you come along.
Okay. Well, I mean, that gives people in different parts of the U.S. An opportunity, again, to actually experience and see and what vMix is all about. Can you give us any insight, perhaps, what Windows 10 vMix is going to look like?
Well, from what we've seen so far, Windows 10 is basically building on what's already available in Windows 8 and adding, I guess, a lot of user interface improvements. So as far as vMix goes, vMix should work out of the box with vMix 10. We'll make sure it works with it before release. The only feature that may be interesting for vMix in the future is the new Direct 3D 12 that they've been talking about. And they've been talking about how that will improve gaming performance, you know, sometimes up to 50%. And so since vMix takes advantage of Direct 3D to do all of the video processing, that could be something we look at in the future, supporting Direct 3D 12 and seeing, you know, if we can get better performance, more cameras, higher resolution, things like that. But as far as Windows 10 goes, from the day one, it should just work all out of the box with the existing feature set available in vMix.
Right. The gentleman said he was doing the Windows 10 preview running vMix 15 now. Said, you know, vMix worked fine. It was just, you know, he's waiting for Windows to get their final release. But it sounds exciting. It really does. Anything else that you can tell us about vMix or what we should know?
Not really. Just that vMix 15 has been out now with Instant Replay for a while. We're just really promoting that at the moment, and then we'll be looking at the next version of vMix probably within a few months down the track.
Okay.
So we're always interested in users coming into our website, vmixhd.com, visiting the forums. We have a feature request section there. So if somebody out there has just this one feature they would really like to see, submit it over in the forums, and if a lot of people vote for it, you might see it in vMix 16.
Okay. All right. Well, I really appreciate, again, your time today and joining us. And we'll put links down below to vMix and to the forums and the vMix Go so they can take a look at all this. And, again, they need to get out to New York and see you. That'd be a good trip. And maybe just jump on down to Florida a little bit later then. And see you. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so great. Thanks for having me.
Oh, thanks for joining me. And I appreciate, again, Mr. Sinclair. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.